Hello friends, welcome to GT Science Tutorial. In this video, I am going to explain about Wedge indices and Miller indices. This is a very important topic because when we talk about crystals, we have to talk about Wedge indices and Miller indices. So in this video, we are going to see what these indices are and we are going to do few numerical problems related to it as well. So let's start. First of all, let's understand about Wedge indices. We know that a crystal is made up of number of planes and faces. So let's use the concept of planes and faces to understand about Wedge indices. For that, let me draw a figure first. First of all, let me draw a three-dimensional axis. Here this is the origin, this is x-axis. This is y-axis and this is z-axis. Now let's draw a plane. This is a plane which is cutting the x-axis at A, y-axis at B and z-axis at C. And the intercept made by the plane in x-axis is small a, in y-axis small b and in z-axis small c. Okay, so this is the plane. Now let's make a face of the crystal. This is the face of the crystal and it is cutting the axis at P, Q and R respectively, and the intercept made by it at x-axis is small p, at y-axis is small q and at z-axis is small r. So this is the complete figure. This is figure planes and faces of crystal, planes and faces of crystal. Okay, now let's write little bit about it. Here the plane means ABC has intercepts small a, small b and small c on x, y and z axis respectively. Okay, similarly the face, this is the face PQR, the face PQR has intercepts small p, small q and small r on the three axis. Okay, then from the figure we can know that OA is written as small a, OB as small b and OC as small c. Similarly, OP is equal to small p, OQ is equal to small q and OR is equal to small r. This is for plane and this is for face, right? Now let me erase this part. Then mathematically or according to rational indices, according to law of rational indices, we can write that the intercept made by the face is a multiple of intercept made by the plane. That is, P will be equal to N A, Q will be equal to N dash B and R will be equal to N double dash C. So this is the condition what the law of rational indices gives us. Here this N, N dash and N double dash are the coefficient of A, B and C. This is trying to say that the plane can be converted into a face if we multiply some numbers to that. Okay, so here this n, n dash and n double dash are the coefficients of the intercepts of plane and let me erase this, n dash and n double dash are known as which indices. So these three terms, n dash and n double dash, are actually called wedge indices. So wedge indices are nothing but the coefficient of the plane to make it a face. Okay, I hope you understood about wedge indices. Now let's understand about Miller indices. We know that the wedge indices are denoted by n, n1 and n2. Now to get the value of Miller indices, first of all we need to convert every indices, that is every wedge indices, into its reciprocal form. Then its reciprocal means just reverse it, that is make the denominator as numerator and numerator as denominator. In this case there is no denominator, so we can divide every value by 1. Now let's take reciprocal, we will get 1 by n1 and 1 by n2. Okay, so the first step is we need to take the reciprocal of each number. Now we need to multiply every value by the LCM of these to convert it into a whole number. That means we need to get the whole number. For that we need to multiply all of these with the smallest possible number, which will convert them into a whole number. And the best way to convert that is multiplying them with the LCM of it. Okay, so multiplying by the LCM of n dash and n double dash will be n dash and n double dash. If we multiply by them to all the three terms, then we will get n dash n double dash by n dash n double dash by n double dash. Now let's cancel the like terms and we will finally get n dash n double dash and n dash. So these are the three numbers. Okay, these are whole numbers that we get by doing different steps. Now these whole numbers that we get are called Miller indices. So let me write the definition of it now. The definition of Miller indices is, when we convert the wedge indices into its reciprocal and multiply each term by a smallest number to convert them into a whole number, then the whole number thus obtained is termed as what is it termed as? It is termed as Miller indices. It is termed as Miller indices. So this is what Miller indices actually is. Now I forgot to say something. Wedge indices means they represent faces, okay, faces of the crystal, and Miller indices means they represent planes of the crystals, okay, and they are denoted by H, K, and L. This is what we use to represent three Miller indices. H is the first Miller indices, K is the second Miller indices, and L is the third Miller indices. And when we write them collectively like HKL, then that means that is a plane. So we represent plane by HKL, writing collectively, okay? And here HKL means Miller indices. Now let's see how to convert Wedge indices into Miller indices, and let's do a numerical problem, okay? Before numerical problem, we need to understand about the application of Miller indices. So Miller indices can be used to calculate the interplanar spacing, that is denoted by DHKL. Interplanar spacing means the distance between two planes, okay? So Miller indices is used to calculate the interplanar spacing, and the formula is DHKL is equal to A by root under H square plus K square plus L square. So this is the formula that is used to calculate the interplanar spacing. Here this D is interplanar spacing, this HKL are Miller indices, and this A is edge length of a cube. So in a cube, we need to measure the edge of the cube, and that is denoted by A. So by using this formula, we can calculate the interplanar spacing experimentally. So this is the experimental method to calculate the interplanar spacing. Now let's see the numerical problem. The question for the numerical problem is, the crystal plane has Wedge indices 1, 1, 1/2. If the edge length is 4.5 angstrom, find the interplanar spacing. So first of all, what is given? The Wedge indices are 1, 1, 1/2. Here the Wedge indices are given, okay? Now first of all, we need to calculate the Miller indices to find out the interplanar spacing. For that, let's calculate the value for Miller indices. Now remember the process. First of all, we need to take the reciprocal of the Wedge indices. So taking the reciprocal, we get there is nothing in the denominator, so we can write 1. Now while taking the reciprocal, just interchange the numerator and denominator, okay? This will be 1, 1, if 2 goes up and 1 goes down, eventually we will get 2. Now all the three values are already whole number. If it was not whole number, then we would multiply with the LCM of all three values to make it a whole number. But as it is already is whole number, so we don't have to multiply by any number. Hence the Miller indices, they are denoted by H, K, L are equal to, this is H, this is K, this is L, 1, 1, 2. So these are the Miller indices. This is 50% of the solution. Now let me draw this upper part. Okay, I hope you have copied everything and I hope you have understood everything. Now we know the Miller indices are this much, that is HKL. Now what is given? Again this A is given, 4.5 angstrom. Here A means edge length, right? Edge length of the cube, that is given to be 4.5 angstrom, and we need to calculate DHKL equals to what, where this DHKL means interplanar spacing between the two planes. Now we know that the formula is DHKL equals to A by root under H square plus K square plus L square. Now let's put the values of each term. A means 4.5 angstrom divided by root under 1 square plus 1 square plus 2 square. Now if we divide everything, if we do all the calculation, we will get 1.84 angstrom. Now this is the required value, that is this is the interplanar spacing between the two planes. So this is how we calculate the Miller indices, and this is how we calculate the interplanar spacing if the sufficient values is given. Now that's all in this video. I hope you understood everything. If you like the video, please share this video as much as you can, and thank you for watching the video.